Popping on YouTube, XRD, and today we're back at it again with the man, the myth, the legend himself, Mr. Arthur Morgan. And today we're gonna continue our journey through the chapter 6.
Leaving again?
Yes, just leaving. I'll see you soon.
Perhaps.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was you, I'd disappear too. This is all pretty much over.
Well, I'll be back.
No, you won't. Let's not pretend no more. Get out of here.
I'll miss you, Arthur. You've been a fine friend to me.
No, let's not get over sentimental. Well, the place is quiet. Get out of here. You go with my blessing.
Thank you, Arthur.
Found a friend looking for you.
Mr. Morgan.
Sir.
How are you?
A little better.
I hope so.
How can I help you?
I'm sorry to impose on you again, but I believe I've made progress brokering peace.
You have?
I believe so. Colonel Favors has agreed to a meeting to discuss and maybe resolve his alleged grievances and mine. Now, he has lied to me more times than I care to remember, but maybe this time he must want peace. Why could he possibly want to humiliate us further?
We got words for his kind, but they're colloquial.
Perhaps I could make one last request. My men are not allowed to carry arms.
You want us to keep the peace?
Yeah, it'll be a lot of dull talking and ceremony. But I feel with some non-tribe members present, their chances of lying or worse will be reduced.
Will you, Arthur?
It ain't my business, brother.
No, I know. But it is mine. Do it for me.
Charles, I got...
I've saved your life. Do it for me.
Sure. Come on. You owe this man. You should have him do your negotiations.
Let's go.
Okay, girl.
This way. I also have some men meeting me there. I wasn't sure if you'd be able to help. Thank you for doing this, both of you. You have already done so much.
Ain't a problem. Just hope nobody recognizes me. I've had a few run-ins with the army recently.
I wish we could have done more to control the situation. Dutch should not have gotten involved.
My son has a mind of his own. Too much so, in fact. I just hope Colonel Favors can be reasoned with. I am not asking for very much, but when our people are sick and hungry, and we find our medicine and supplies are being deliberately withheld, how can we not view that as something personal? When they destroy our sacred sites, how can I convince Eagle Flies and the others that they shouldn't fight back?
Maybe that's part of the reason they're doing these things. Because they want you to fight. Be able to say, look, you see... how these savages behave?
Perhaps. Thank you for helping Captain Monroe to retrieve those vaccines, Arthur. He will be at the meeting and is one person who knows the true situation, at least. I still have hope that we can come to an agreement.
Thank you.
Sounds good.
Here we are. There's my men up ahead.
Hello.
Whoa. We chasha kela na kola wichiampi. Yopo, bunyapi ktelo. This way. Colonel Favors, Captain Munro, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Hmm. Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not.
Yeah.
Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name, what is it?
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion. Keep breaking peace treaties we've made, causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... Are you okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said... Are you being facetious, Captain Munro?
No, sir, I am not.
Chief Rains.
That's, Rains' fault.
Exactly. Chief Rains,
quite a cough.
Federal government.
Sure.
Wait here. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Munro court-martialed. Or attempt to. He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Munro? He seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Munro is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he had something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Munro is going to force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Munro.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason. And hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. His whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Munro. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate.
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive.
So?
I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? Was that its plan too, sir? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Hi.
Captain Monroe, let's get out of here.
If I were you,
I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shall.
Get off me.
Charles, Captain Monroe, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
Time to get out of here. Come on. Don't be dumb.
You son of a bitch.
Think about what you're doing.
Open fire on them.
Monroe.
More incoming! Man, please hold your fire! We're gonna win.
We should scout to see how you like it.
Hold your fire!
Damn it, barely hit him.
Really? What do we do now?
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talk. They was gonna have you hanged for treason. You can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
You can't worry about that now.
I guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so.
here, Captain Monroe?
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. You take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet you back at camp.
Reverend? Reverend. What are you doing here?
I'm leaving.
Running away?
Yeah, I suppose so. I'm running away. I tried to make Dutch see sense, but he's very strange recently.
And the women? Little Jack? You're leaving?
I told them to run, too. I asked them to come with me, and they wouldn't. I've changed. I'm a changed man, Arthur. I won't die over some nonsense spouted by a fool.
I ain't changed. I'm still a bad man.
Maybe your path isn't changing, Arthur.
My path is coming to an end, Reverend.
I know, son. I know. And I know that you will face your destiny like a man, like a warrior. Because that's what you are.
That's all I am. A fighter, a killer, and a crazy man.
So be it. You lived your way, you'll die your way. But in the time that you have left, don't compromise. And you'll do everything that you have to do just fine.
We'll see.
I don't have to see. I know you. Fight and keep fighting.
Okay. Good luck out there.
Be true to yourself, Mr. Morgan. And leave the lies and the hypocrisy to fools like me.
Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you like the video. If you do, please share and subscribe. Smack that like button. Turn on the notifications. You'll never miss a video. See you in the next one. Peace.